President Trump has been an unusual president in the fact that he didn't have really any political experience before he was elected to the top political job in this country, the most powerful world leader. And he has a different perspective. You see that with how he's been negotiating these deals within the Middle East, but also confronting China. For so long, China was ripping off American companies. We were granting them access into the World Trade Organization, giving them permanent trade relationships, hoping that they were going to democratize. And President Trump, you know, from the 1980s on, has been very consistent with trade deals and saying, you know, why are we letting all these other countries rip us off? We need to stand up for ourselves. And that is very America first. And so he did not take the status quo relationship. Instead, he placed tariffs on China, which were very controversial at the time, but it brought them to the negotiating table. Now you have a phase one deal with China. You also had him renegotiate NAFTA, which was bleeding our country dry from its manufacturing base. And so I think these policy proposals really connect him with the forgotten men and women in this country who elected him, and also make him very different than the status quo politicians in our past.
Yeah.
Nothing really stuck. And I don't think this Atlantic piece is going to stick either. For one reason, it's all of these sources are unnamed. No one, you know, all the whistleblowers that come forth that, you know, set off the Ukrainian investigation are unnamed. They're unknown. No one wants to put the money where their mouth is and put their name on it and own it. And because of that, and because the whole Russia collusion conspiracy hoax was based on these unnamed leaked sources, the American public has just simply lost trust in the media. What is or what is not true, and these sneers just don't stick with us anymore.